snow. Every snowflake is different. It takes about an hour for each one to reach the ground. Its form changes as it sluggishly falls from the sky. And you might wonder if there's a deep analogy following these facts. The answer is no. But you can subscribe and push the notification bell. It won't take you an hour. Shameless plug. What's up, guys? I really just want to share this trick that I use when I edit my voiceovers today. So let's get it. So you got your shots on your timeline and you start recording your voiceover. And just in case if you need to know how to do that in Final Cut Pro, you can go here in Window and record voiceover. Or you can press Shift Command A. Of course, you can also just record externally and then import the audio into Final Cut Pro. But when you have your audio on the timeline, I recommend to create a new storyline right away. You see, a new storyline will put the connected audio in one place, and you can make edit inside it without worrying about the main timeline too much. So right click, create storyline, or select, and then Command Z. You see this grayish thing right here? This will tell you that the audio clips are in a new storyline. So as an example, if I feel like this shot is too long, I can trim it. Or if I don't like it, I can just delete it and none of the connected audio will be affected because the storyline is connected to this first clip right here. But let's say I want more pause between these two shots. To create a gap within the storyline, I'm just gonna use the position tool here, or just press P and then click on the audio you want to move and then drag it to where you want it to be. Final Cut Pro will create a gap automatically. I'm telling you guys, the position tool is a really cool tool, but we're not done yet, so let's get back to it. If you decide to get rid of the storyline, and I mean it's an if, you don't have to, but you can select it and make sure you're selecting the storyline, not one of the medias you cut. Select it and then press Shift Command G. And check this out, guys. Now all the audio clips are individually connected to the clip right on top of it. And if you happen to want to switch around some of the clips, the audio will follow it. And that's it. If you guys got any value from this video, subscribe and go check out these tips for Final Cut Pro users. And I will see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.